$8 trillion of global government bonds have negative interest rates. That's 30% of all the global government bonds outstanding in the world, trading with yields under 0%. But that's really just been a continuation of the trend we've seen since the Great Recession of 2008, where central banks have been lowering rates, lower and lower zero, and now they've gone negative. And they've really done that for two reasons to try and help their economy. Number one is to force people out of the presumed safe haven of government bonds into riskier assets like stocks. If stock prices go up, people feel wealthier, they spend more money, the economy does better, GDP goes up. The second way negative interest rates can help an economy is through depreciating that country's currency. So everybody competes in the marketplace for global goods. If your currency goes down, then the goods you manufacture become more competitive in that global marketplace. You can sell more of them. So it benefits your manufacturing sector, benefits your exports, and that helps your GDP that way as well. Well, that's a good question. It sounds crazy, and I can tell you that if you buy a bond with a negative yield and you hold it to maturity, you are 100% guaranteed to lose money on that bond. So why would you do that? Well, there aren't a lot of good reasons, but I could probably think of a few of them. One would be if you were convinced that we're going to have deflation in the future. If things are going to be cheaper to buy in the future, then you should put off buying today, stick that money in a bond, even if it generates a negative yield for you. Because if the rate of deflation exceeds the rate of interest, negative interest on that bond, then you're going to be better off from a purchasing power standpoint. So number one reason would be if you think there's going to be deflation. Second reason would be if you're concerned there's going to be an imminent and large decline in the stock market. If you think stocks are going to crash, you'll take that guaranteed small loss in the safety of a government bond as opposed to an unknown but potentially large loss in the stock market. Third reason that people buy bonds with negative yields is they just have to. If you're a portfolio manager and you run a mutual fund or an ETF that's indexed against a bond index, if that index holds bonds with negative yields, you got to buy those bonds regardless because you're trying to match that index. The fourth type of investor who would purchase a bond with a negative interest rate would be a central bank, particularly central banks that are doing quantitative easing. They actually like to buy bonds with low yields. The lower, the better. The more negative, the better from their standpoint, because again, they feel that's going to force investors out of government bonds and into what they believe are more productive assets like high yield bonds and stock markets that can benefit the economy through that wealth effect that we talked about earlier.